welcome to Bite Size Med. This video is on the different types of muscle tissue. Now I've done each of these in more detail, and I'll leave links to those in the description box below in case you need them. But this video is more of a summary where I'm going to be putting some of it together. There are three kinds of muscle tissue: skeletal, smooth, and cardiac muscle. First up, where are they located? Skeletal muscle, like the name suggests, is attached to the skeleton, so bones. These would be muscles like the quadriceps femoris, the hamstrings, etc. Smooth muscle is mostly found lining hollow viscera. That's organs that have a space or a cavity inside, like the gastrointestinal tract, the uterus, the bladder, blood vessels. They also form the ciliary muscles in the eye. Cardiac muscle is obviously specific to the heart. It lines the walls of the chambers and the septa as a part of the myocardium. Based on their location, their function becomes more obvious. The skeletal muscles are important for movement, balance, tone, posture, things like that. Smooth muscles, well, that would depend on their location. They're important for maintaining tone of visceral organs, for peristalsis, constriction and dilation of blood vessels, eye accommodation, etc. And cardiac muscle is needed for contraction and relaxation of the heart. The skeletal muscle could be of two types depending on their metabolism: type 1 and type 2 fibers. The type 1 are white fibers and the type 2 are red fibers. Type 2 are further divided into type 2A and type 2B fibers. Smooth muscle can also be of two types: single unit and multi-unit. Single unit smooth muscle cells work together like a syncytium, hence they're called syncytial smooth muscle. Multi-unit smooth muscles work more independently because their innervation is more separate. Cardiac muscle has two types of cells: contractile cells, which line the walls of the atria and the ventricles, such that when they contract, it generates force and the pressure in the chamber rises. The other type of cell is the conducting cells. These are specialized muscle cells. They are responsible for the conduction of action potentials through the heart by forming the cardiac conduction system. Both skeletal and cardiac muscles have cylindrical fibers, but cardiac muscles have branches. Skeletal muscles don't have that. And smooth muscle cells are spindle-shaped. Skeletal muscles have multiple peripheral nuclei in each fiber. Cardiac muscle cells have one or two central nuclei, and smooth muscle cells have a single central nucleus. The cells in cardiac muscle are joined together end to end by anchoring cell junctions called intercalated discs. These discs have gap junctions so that ions can spread from cell to cell, ensuring that they all depolarize together and contract together like a syncytium. Single-unit smooth muscle cells also have gap junctions, so they contract together as well. But multi-unit smooth muscles have few to no gap junctions, so they contract more independently. As do skeletal muscles. They don't have gap junctions. Each fiber has its own innervation. Those nerves are somatic nerves. Their axons branch at their termination, forming a junction with the muscle membrane. That's called the neuromuscular junction. Smooth muscles are supplied by autonomic nerves, the sympathetic and the parasympathetic system, but they have varicosities at their terminations containing the neurotransmitter. Cardiac muscles are supplied by autonomic nerves as well, but these nerves don't initiate contraction of the muscle unlike with the other two. They only modulate contraction. The impulse for contraction of cardiac muscle comes from self-generating potentials in the pacemaker of the heart, that's the sinoatrial node. All of these muscles are excitable cells, so they have action potentials, but they're different kinds. In skeletal muscles, the action potential looks like that of a nerve, with a depolarizing upstroke, a repolarizing downstroke, hyperpolarization, and return to resting membrane potential. In cardiac muscle, the contractile cells of the atria and the ventricles have an action potential that looks more like this. They have a depolarizing upstroke, early repolarization, a plateau, and late repolarization. The plateau is because of calcium entry. But the pacemaker of the heart, the sinoatrial node, it has a self-generating pacemaker potential with a depolarization and repolarization. but because of sodium leak through funny channels, the potential comes up the threshold on its own to fire another action potential. Smooth muscles can have different kinds, spike potentials, action potentials with plateaus, but some smooth muscles can also have a slow wave rhythm. These are self-generating, and when they reach threshold, there will be spikes on top. These are called pacemaker potentials. But in the end, all these action potentials cause calcium inside the cell to rise. However, the source of this calcium in skeletal muscle is solely the sarcoplasmic reticulum because it's very well developed. They have T-tubules at the junction of every A and I band, so there are two in every sarcomere. Cardiac muscle has T-tubules as well, but one at every Z-disc. And remember that calcium enters the sarcoplasm during the plateau phase of the action potential, so the source of calcium is both the extracellular fluid and the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Smooth muscle has a very poorly developed sarcoplasmic reticulum, so its main source of calcium is the extracellular fluid. That calcium binds to troponin C in both skeletal and cardiac muscle. Troponin C is part of the thin filaments, along with troponin I, T, tropomyosin, and actin. The thick filaments have myosin, and these alternate regularly. The thin filaments attach to a Z-disc. The structure between two Z-discs is a sarcomere. This regular arrangement gives rise to cross striations. Smooth muscles don't have this regular arrangement, so they are not striated. They don't have sarcomeres. They have actin and myosin, and the actin filaments attach to dense bodies instead of the Z-discs. They also don't have troponin. Instead, they have calmodulin, which binds to calcium. Smooth muscles use a myosin light chain kinase and myosin light chain phosphatase for contraction and relaxation, which skeletal and cardiac muscles don't use. But ultimately, the calcium results in the sliding of thin filaments over thick filaments in all three types of muscle, resulting in shortening of the muscle, that's a contraction. When the calcium levels inside the cells of all these three muscles rise, the muscles contract. And when their intracellular calcium levels come back down again, the muscles relax. And those are some of the similarities and differences between skeletal, smooth, and cardiac muscles. I hope this video was helpful. If it was, you can give it a like and subscribe to my channel. If you would like more videos with comparisons like this, leave me a comment below. And if you've got any topics in mind, be sure to let me know so I can try and make them. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.